Hey, it's Coach Justin from Ultimate Baseball Training, and in this video, we're talking about teaching your kids hitting, and I'm gonna go over some important keys that I think you should focus on. The first key I think you should focus on when it comes to working on hitting with your kids or just anything baseball related with your kids is fun and overall enjoyment of the game. And the reason why is because, number one, baseball is a game, okay? It's called the game for a reason. Games are supposed to be fun. It's not a life or death situation, and I get being competitive. I'm very competitive, and I understand that winning is a lot of times more fun than just the experience of going out and playing. You want to win. You want to do well. Any competitive athlete wants to perform at a high level. But that being said, the majority of players out there, if you look at the numbers, are not going to play at the next level, whatever the next level is, whether that's high school, college, professionally. Not every single player is going to play at that next level, so they might as well enjoy the level that they're currently at. They might as well have fun with their best friends. They're out in the beautiful sunshine on a baseball field having fun with their friends, and they better enjoy that time with you as well, because if you played this game or any sport, you know just how fast a career goes and just how fast life goes. It's over like that in the blink of an eye. So, you know, it'd be a shame if they didn't have fun and if they ended up quitting the game of baseball because they didn't enjoy it. So every single time, you should always emphasize, whether you're at practice, whether you're talking about a game setting, it should always be the most important thing is fun and enjoyment of the game, because most players are not going to play at that next level. And the reality is, when you have fun, when you laugh, when you smile, when you joke around, you play better anyway. You're loose, you're relaxed, you're having fun, you play better. Look at big leaguers, right? They've got millions and millions of dollars on the line, right? I mean, their job, that is literally their job. For them, it's not just 100% about fun. It's about, they have to perform at their job. But how many of them do you see, you know, smiling on the field, cracking jokes with their buddies? They're paying attention, they're focused, but they're having fun, they're enjoying themselves, they're enjoying the game. So that has to be the overarching principle when you're teaching your kids hitting or teaching your kids anything to do with baseball or any other sport. You've got to make it fun for them. You've got to allow them to enjoy the game. All right, now let's get into some good stuff. The next big key I think you should focus on is vision. And when I say vision, I think it's very important that you consistently work on picking the ball up out of the pitcher's window. That's so important. Recognizing pitches. You got to understand, is it a fastball coming out of the hand? Is it a changeup? Is it a curveball? You know, is it something firm or is it something a little bit softer, right? You've got to understand that. So you got to be able to pick up pitches out of the window. And then you've got to really overemphasize watching the baseball with hitters, you know, all the way to the hitting zone, to the point of contact, and keeping their head down through contact as they drive through the baseball and get to extension. But vision is so important. That's a big key. That's more important than, you know, how strong they are in the weight room and bat speed and all that sort of stuff. That stuff is very, very important for hitters, but at the end of the day, if you don't see the baseball, none of that matters, because you'll have great bat speed on a swing and miss, right? So at the end of the day, we got to have fun, and then we've got to see the baseball. That should be step one. I know it sounds like an elementary tip because it's the first thing that you hear, oh, watch the ball, watch the ball, watch the ball, but it's so, so important. So you should always prioritize that. That's a big key. Do whatever it takes to consistently help your kid out with vision and seeing the baseball. The third big key you should focus on when teaching your kids hitting is timing. Pitchers are gonna have a lot of success on the mound when they disrupt a hitter's timing. So as a hitter, you're gonna have a lot more success if you arrive on time. And this is one of those topics that gets pushed to the back burner, just like vision, but I think it's so important because, you know, there's a lot better topics that we can talk about that are more attractive, like launch angle and exit velocity and attack angle and all that sort of stuff. But at the end of the day, just like with vision, timing is so, so important, and good things happen. Things tend to fall into place for your kid's swing when they arrive on time. I've seen, and I'm sure you can attest to this too, I've seen hitters who, you know, have ugly swings, but they have great timing and they find a way to consistently get hits and get on base because their timing is good. And I've seen hitters who in BP, they look great, on a tee they look great, right? But in a real game, they're consistently earlier, they're consistently late, they just can't get that timing piece down. And so more mechanical problems start showing up in games and they can't find themselves on base consistently, and it's all because of timing. So elementary stuff here, we're working from the ground, we're building that foundation, and we're getting into more advanced things as we go. But you got to have fun, you got to, you know, really prioritize vision and seeing the ball, and then really prioritize timing. Just with vision and timing alone, you're going to develop a pretty good hitter. So focus on that. Timing is so important. Another big key I think you should work on with your kid when you're teaching them hitting is plate discipline and swinging at good pitches, because hitting is hard enough. It's really, really difficult. And so we don't want to make it any harder on ourselves by swinging at pitches that are outside the strike zone. So I would recommend teach your kids to be aggressive, because it's very difficult if you get a hitter who's way too patient, way too passive, who doesn't want to swing the bat. It's hard to get them to actually want to do it. So you should always teach them to be aggressive, but you want them to be aggressive on strikes and patient on pitches that are outside the strike zone. Make the pitcher work. Make him throw the ball over the plate. And remember, with plate discipline, it starts with you. If you're working with your kid and you're throwing them batting practice, plate discipline starts in batting practice. So don't force them to swing at every single pitch. They should, you know, have strike zone awareness and plate discipline even in batting practice, because the more they start to expand the zone and swing at borderline pitches in BP, the more they're gonna do that in a real game situation as well. So good hitters consistently swing at good pitches. If you swing at pitches that are bad pitches, pitches that are outside the strike zone, you're not doing yourself any favors, you're getting yourself out. So plate discipline, swinging at strikes is so important. Another big key you should work on with them is hitting the ball where it's pitched. Ken Griffey Jr. calls this jousting, okay? You're jousting with the pitcher. Him and Don Baylor were having a conversation, a great conversation, behind a cage one day, and it was recorded, and they talked about one of the most common tendencies for young players is they want to hit everything to the opposite field. They want to go the other way way too much. And I would encourage you, again, when you're working with your kids, when you're throwing them BP, make sure they're hitting the ball where it's pitched. So in other words, if it's an outside pitch, then yes, they can let the ball travel a little bit more and they can hit that ball to the opposite field. But they should not be hitting outside pitches. They should not be pulling those pitches. If it's an inside pitch, then yes, they're gonna hit the ball a little bit further out in front like this and they're gonna pull that. If it's a pitch over the middle of the plate, they should be staying gap to gap in the middle of the field. They shouldn't be hooking it foul to their pull side. They shouldn't be taking that to the opposite field, right? They should stay in the middle of the field because that's where the ball was pitched. And then again, on an away pitch, then you can go to the opposite field. But I think that's so important for hitters. You got to be able to hit the ball at the correct contact point, and you've got to be able to spray it around the yard depending on, again, where the pitcher locates that pitch. And last but certainly not least, we're getting a little bit more advanced here. I think another big key you should work on with your players is about plan and approach, okay? So making sure that they're in the right headspace when they're at the plate. They don't want to be brain heavy. They don't want to be thinking way too many thoughts, but it is important for them to step up to the plate with some type of plan, some type of approach. So, you know, ask them questions like, okay, what do you think, what was the situation, all right? What do you think the pitcher was trying to do there? And then how are you planning on counteracting that? What was your plan when you stepped into the batter's box? Super, super important. And then make sure that their head is in the right spot when it comes to, at the end of the day, when we're talking about outcomes, you win if you hit the ball hard. Good things happen when you hit the ball hard, okay? So it's not necessarily about hits, it's not necessarily about batting average, because those are things that are outside of your control, right? But what you can control is things like swinging at good pitches and hitting the ball hard somewhere. So make sure that they're in the right headspace with that. So that's it. I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please do me a favor and leave it a like. I'd really appreciate that. And be sure to subscribe to the channel if you enjoy these types of instructional videos. That way you never miss any of our upcoming videos that we're coming out with every single week that are designed specifically to help you improve your game. So click that subscribe button. And last thing, hitters, I put together a free resource for you that I know you're gonna love. It's called the Contact Point Checklist. It's 100% free. You can download it right now. Just click on the first link down there in the description. But what I've done is I've freeze framed the swing at the point of contact, and I've highlighted a few key areas that you need to make sure your swing has in order to really maximize your bat speed and your power and your consistency at the plate as a hitter. So 100% free. I know it's going to help you take your hitting to that next level. So go download that right now. Click on the link down below. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next one.